behind closed doors. This is Wendy. In today's episode, I'd like to bring you on the Sex and the City Carrie Bradshaw inspired house hunting tour. In part one, we will walk around the neighborhood and go to the film scene of Carrie's apartment. And part two, we're gonna go into Carrie's exact apartment, but I want to bring you inside a brownstone apartment to relive the life of Carrie. Then in part three, in the show, she went to so many nice restaurants and also eateries. I'm going to bring you to this place that you should definitely check out. And make sure that you stay until the end, because at the end, I will share with you how much would a place like this cost. Let's get started. Hey, if it's your first time on my channel and you're very interested in the TV show and movie inspired house hunting tours, make sure that you click on the subscribe button down below and turn on the notification. Now comment down below and let me know which character in Sex and the City is your favorite. Today we are going to visit the film scene of Carrie from Sex and the City's apartment. The funny thing about this that I heard is that even though in the show she is supposed to be living on the Upper East Side with the Upper East Side address, in reality the whole filming of the exterior of her apartment is located down in West Village. So that's it. If we're lucky enough to go visit both units to see the different feel of the neighborhood and also the exterior of the brownstone. Looking for 245 East 73rd Street, 225th. Wow, it's beautiful inside. Lovely. Oh, and moving on to 35th next door and then 241 down the street. So let's continue a few more. Wait, across the street is 301. So this must be the building. Carrie's apartment is supposed to be the 245th East 73rd Street. Wow, it's on the Upper East Side, but totally not a brownstone at all. So let's go down to the actual place where she filmed the Sex and the City scene. Hi, it's a new day. Yesterday on the Upper East Side, trying to find Carrie's apartment address, it didn't turn out to be anywhere close to what we see in Sex and the City. So today we are moving downtown to West Village because this is where the exterior of Carrie's famous brownstone was filmed. And we are now on Perry Street or Westford, moving down to try to find the location. 64 Perry is what we are trying to look for. Continue down in one or two blocks, that should bring us to that famous brownstone. Walking down West 4, and this should be the cross street of Perry. Yes, we are here, and we will make it right. And here we are, 64 Perry, and wow. There are fans everywhere. They even block the stairs for private use. But since there's fan taking pictures, this must be the place. The last time this brownstone was sold, it was back in 2013. And at that time when it was sold at 13 million. It's a three-story, five-bedroom townhouse. Also, a fun fact about this place is that in the show, Carrie is the writer, so she cannot afford to really pay a fortune, definitely not 14 million to buy this townhouse. But in the story, this is meant to be a brownstone with several apartments, and she is renting a rent-stabilized studio and paying 700 per month. Well, Since we cannot go in to see this exact brownstone, and definitely there's no studio brownstone for Carrie, I'm going to bring you inside a brownstone and visit an apartment that really reminds me of Carrie's home, looking down at the tree-lined street. Going to see, and it's very similar to the brownstone that Carrie Bradshaw from Sex and the City lives. It's a historical pre-war building, and that's going there to have a look. And it's very interesting because in the show that she's living in a studio because she's a poor writer, but in reality, these kind of brownstone cost a lot. The moment we open the door, it's like going back to the 1900s where this building was first built. It does have the historical and old building look, but with a fresh design and a fresh smell. All right, so that's going there to see this apartment. Immediately coming in here to the right-hand side is the bathroom with bathtub, good size, everything is functional. And to the left-hand side is the storage space for the closet. Interestingly, this closet connects all the way to the back to the bedroom. So it's a very smart use of space, and you can also further make improvement to expand that or reconfigure a little bit, almost like a walk-in closet, mini walk-in closet. And because this place is of the high ceiling, of course, then you also have additional storage space on the top to make the best use of it. Very quickly turn around, we arrive at the living room area. This is a brownstone apartment, and this red brick wall really represent the key characteristic of a New York brownstone. It's gorgeous. The window is facing south and east. If you have watched my channel for a while, you know that I care a lot about the orientation of the apartment. So I like that in the morning and in the afternoon time, I will be able to get the sunlight shedding to my living room, to my bedroom. Then continue along the red brick wall, we arrive at the kitchen. Kitchen is full functioning, it has all the appliances that you need, and the red brick wall really just adds a characteristic to it. Things are new, renovated a few years ago. I think it will work just fine. Then spinning the head around to look up above the kitchen is an extra brownie point. They have a loft area, currently it's used somehow for mini storage space, but also big enough to have a mattress there as a tiny guest room. Then let's go into the bedroom. This bedroom has a good layout and size that you can easily fit into a queen size bed. All right, we say that this episode is inspired by Sex and the City, Carrie. So we have to check out the closet and make sure there's enough space. So in the bedroom, right next to it is the huge closet space. It goes so deep. As you can see, wow. Before we move on, comment down below and let me know how much do you think a brownstone, a one bedroom apartment on the Upper East Side is going to cost? I'll share the answer at the end. Alright, so now let's go down the street. I'm going to bring you to the famous Carrie's Cupcake, the Magnolia Bakery. I heard it's going to be super delicious. trying the Magnolia Bakery cupcake. This is the vanilla cupcake with the strawberry frosting, the Carrie's cake. And yours?
I think this one's a hummingbird.
Hummingbird
cupcake, yeah.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Enjoy. So Patty, how do you like the apartment that we went to? The Carrie's apartment.
Do you like
brownstones overall?
I love it. I think it's a dream.
Yeah?
It's really
nice.
Funny. I mean,
nice.
Yeah.
So living the dream, starting with a cupcake.
Yep.
All right. So I hope you are very satisfied with the little sweet stuff. And now I'm going to share with you the price. The price of this apartment is... $750,000. Did you guess it? And that is all for today. Thank you so much for joining me today on the Girly Sex and City Carrie House Hunting Tour. I hope you liked the episode. Make sure that you click on the subscribe button down below and turn on the notification and leave me a comment if there are certain shows, certain movies that you want me to feature next time. I will see you next time.